Hello students, hope you all are well. Let us start our next video on the basis of elements of account standard 11 part 2. The last video I taught you the theoretical part of the second chapter, which is called depreciation. Now in this video I will teach you the practical sums slowly from the illustration 1 of page number 32. Here I told you that you are having total 10 chapters. Out of that, first two chapters practical sums are included. That two chapters practical sums you have to make practice. Out of that first one, the first one is called the straight line method or fixed installment method, that we will see. Now let me read the question, what is given in this question and what you have to do and how you have to do. If you understand that one illustration, one or two illustrations, remaining illustrations, you will feel it is easy. Let us see what is given in the questions. Question number, illustration number 1, page number 32. That Sheela Limited has purchased a machine, cost was 48,000. That is, price is 48,000 on 1/4. Date and price you will pay attention very carefully. 1/4/12. 1/4/12 means past April. So in accounting year, it is the financial year. And it started from the April and it will end in the month of March. The installation expense of this machine was ₹2,000. That means your purchase price is 48 and installation expense 2,000 will be added. So your cost price will be 48 plus 2 is equal to 50. Estimated life of the machine is 10 years. This machine will work, it is decided that this machine will work for 10 years. After 10 years, the machine you have to sell. And if you sell this machine after 10 years, you will get 10,000. Scrap value. Scrap value of the machine is, it is expected to be 10,000. Determine the annual depreciation. Abhi aapko find karna hai. Annual amount of depreciation. Annual depreciation rate under the straight line method of depreciation. Accounting year of the company, it is ending on 31st March. Prepare the journal entries. Aapko journal entry find karna hai. लिखना है मशीन अकाउंट फाइंड ओपन करना है लेजर डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू ओपन एंड फर्स्ट थ्री इयर्स दिस यू हैव टू डू एंड डिस्क्लोज द अकाउंटिंग इफेक्ट इन द फाइनल अकाउंट ऑफ द फर्स्ट ईयर फाइनल अकाउंट में फर्स्ट ईयर का फाइनल अकाउंट में क्या क्या आपको तो वन बाई वन लेट अस सी फर्स्ट टू फाइंड आउट द सीपी कॉस्ट प्राइस 48,000 इज द परचेस प्राइस प्लस 2,000 इज द इंस्टॉलेशन चार्ज व्हिच इज कमिंग 50,000. Number 1. Estimated life. It is given 10 years. 10 years estimated is the life. Okay. Next is coming that it is given the scrap value. Scrap value, it is given 10,000. What is the और कुछ नहीं है एंड यू परचेज दिस मशीन ऑन 1/4/12 सो योर सीपी इज 50,000 यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द अमाउंट ऑफ डिप्रिसिएशन ऑन सीपी एस्टिमेटेड लाइफ इज 10 इयर्स स्क्रैप वैल्यू इज 10,000 दिस आर द थिंग्स इज गिवन एंड यू हैव परचेज दिस मशीन ऑन 1/4/12 एंड दे से दैट वन द यू कैलकुलेट द अमाउंट ऑफ डिप्रिसिएशन Now, number 1, annual amount of depreciation. First one, annual amount of depreciation. Annual amount of depreciation, it is called D. And D is equal to C minus S. By N. याद रखना है the D is equal to annual amount of depreciation, C is equal to cost price, S means scrap value, N means estimated lifetime. So cost price is how much? 50. Scrap value is how much? 10. N is equal to numbers of years, although estimated lifespan of the machine. So you will get it here 50,000 minus 10,000 divided by 10 is equal to 40,000 divided by 10 is equal to 40. This is called your answer for that D, which is coming for the second question is coming rate of depreciation. Second, rate of depreciation. Rate of depreciation formula, it is given R is equal to, which is called R, and R is equal to, it is given that D by C into 100. D is equal to 4000, C is equal to 50,000 into 100, which comes 8% inflation. The answer for second. So once again you follow, annual amount of depreciation is called D. D ka formula is C minus S by N. C means cost price of the machines, S means scrap value of the machines, N means numbers of years. Cost price is 50,000, scrap value is 10,000, and numbers of years is 10. So it comes 4,000. Rate of depreciation is equal to R. R ka formula hota hai, R is equal to D by C into 100. D is equal to 4,000, C is equal to 5,000, and cost is equal to 8%. Next question is coming, that determine the annual amount of depreciation, annual depreciation rate under the straight line method of depreciation, and accounting year of the company is ending on 31st March, prepare the journal entries. Now, journal entries for how many years? 3 years. This machine is working for 10 years. How long this machine will work? 10 years. But they did not tell you to do the journal entries for 10 years. They said do the journal entries for 3 years. So you will do the journal entries. This is the format for journal entries. Every one of you know. Once again, follow. Journal entries, first sum I am doing. Second sum onwards, journal entries I will not do. Without doing the journal entries, directly we will do the ledger. So, first sum you follow the journal entries. How many years you will use the machine? 10 years. But they did not tell you to do the journal entries for all 10 years. Do the journal entries for 3 years that they said. Okay? Now when you buy the machines, you have purchased the machines on 1/4. Well, 1/4 you have purchased the machines. When you purchase the machines, that time how much you paid for buying these machines? 48,000. So you write here machinery account debit. Two bank, two cash, 48 bank में payment हुआ और 2000 cash में payment हुआ, total 50,000. Actually cost of the machine is 48. The journal should be machine account debit to bank 48, but 2000 you have paid for installation charges. You know that one, installation charges if you pay. For that installation charge account debit will not come. Machine account debit will come. So that will be added in this. So machine account debit, two bank, two cash. That is for this. Next journal. Next journal, what is this? At the end of the year, you have to charge the depreciation. And for charging the depreciation, you have to pass one journal. Once again, you follow. This is the first date of this year, first year. फर्स्ट ईयर के फर्स्ट ईयर है मशीन परचेस किया अभी पूरा साल में डेप्रिसिएशन चार्ज नहीं किया डेप्रिसिएशन भी चार्ज होगा एंड ऑफ द ईयर एंड ईयर एंड्स ऑन 31st 30 31st 30 में चार्ज करना है or you are charging the depreciation means you are reducing the price of the machines. And how much you have to charge? It is given, you calculated it, every year you are charging, I think 4,000. Annual amount of depreciation you have charged, you calculated it, and it was 4,000. So 4,000 every year you have to charge. Like that, first year is 50, so first year 4, it comes 46. Second year again 4, it comes 42. Third year again it is 4, it comes 30. Like that, it will go on. So, depreciation, whenever you are charging, depreciation is one type of loss or expense, so it is a debit. And necessary account, the revenue is reducing. For that, you have to remember it. Depreciation account debit to necessary account. How much charges? Necessary, no?
Yes.
Or necessary account, whatever you want. And one more entry will come in the first year, that is the amount of depreciation what you have charged, that you have to close it. Matlab, depreciation account you have to close, or depreciation account you have to transfer to the profit and loss account. Profit and loss account you have to transfer to the account. The depreciation debit may aaya tha, same debt pe. 31st day, 13 days. Debit may aaya tha, usko maine credit mein kar diya. Or ye amount profit and loss account mein transfer kar diya. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation. Which is coming 4,000. So first year you will get 3 journal entries. One for buying the machine, that is the first journal, and then for charging the depreciation, second journal, and then for transferring this depreciation to the profit and loss account is the third journal. So first year you will get 3 journals. Now second year you will get 2 journals. One for charging the depreciation and another for transferring. Because second year you are not buying the machines. Is clear to you? So second year is the first journal entries, not this one. Second year below, number 2. And when you charge the depreciation, 31st be 14 days. At the end of second year, first year it was end of 31st 3, 13. Second year will end and 31st will be 14. You will charge the same journal. Depreciation account debit to machine, charge the and in the same day, 31st will be 14, you have to transfer this one, which same journal will come, the population will debit to depreciation. Second year is over. So first year you are getting 3 journal, second year you got the 2 journal. One for charging the depreciation and the for transferring the depreciation to the profit and loss account. You will not pass any journal for buying the machine from second year. Now third year. Third year ends when 31st 3 15. Again same journal. Depreciation account debit to machine charge and profit and loss account debit to depreciation charge. It will go on. So first year 3 journal, baad mein every year 2 journals you have to pass. One for charging the, so you have to remember only 3 journals. First year for buying the machines, that is machine account debit to bank to cash. Generally, lump sum amount we are paying through check for that we load bank. Small amount we are paying through cash, we are for that we load cash. So first journal is machine account debit to bank to cash. Second journal depreciation account debit to machinery. And third journal profit and loss account debit to depreciation. Next year, 2 journals. Depreciation account debit to machinery and profit loss account debit to depreciation. Next year, 2 journals. So, total you got the 7 journals. So, you remember it, all these 7 journals. I think you have not forgotten. This 7 journal. Now this 7 journal will do the posting in machinery account and depreciation account. In your question it is said that past the generalities that you have done, then necessary account and depreciation account you have to open for depreciation account for past 3 years. So you open the two ledger. One is handwriting here, depreciation account. Another is handwriting here. Next area. This is middle line. You understand now? Now journal को ledger में posting करना है. How many ledgers you have to open? Not all. Profit and loss account ledger I have not opened. Bank account ledger I have not opened. In your journal, bank account was there, cash account was there, profit and loss account was there. Out of that, only the two I have opened. One is machine account and this depreciation account. That is it. Now you remember that journal. First journal, what was it was? First journal was machine account debit to bank to cash. Is not it? Machine account debit to bank to cash. So two bank to cash posting will not be there. Only machine account posting over. So machine account debit 1412 to bank to cash. That is 48 or 2. First journal posting over. First journal machine account debit to bank to cash. मैं मशीन अकाउंट एंड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट ओपन किया. बैंक अकाउंट एंड कैश अकाउंट वी हैव नॉट ओपन. सो फर्स्ट जर्नल पोस्टिंग वाज ओवर. सेकंड जर्नल 31/3/13 था डेट एंड इट वाज द डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू मशीनरी. दैट जर्नल वाज देयर. तो यू पोस्टिंग डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट दैट इज 31/3/13 डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू मशीनरी. हाउ मच? 4,000. डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू मशीनरी. और यह मशीनरी भी पोस्टिंग होगा बिकॉज सेकेंड जर्नल डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट एंड मशीनरी अकाउंट क्रेडिट. तो दोनों में पोस्टिंग होगा. तो डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू मशीनरी एंड मशीनरी अकाउंट क्रेडिट बाय डेप्रिसिएशन. हाउ मच? 4,000. थर्ड जर्नल प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट डेबिट टू डेप्रिसिएशन. कितना में पोस्टिंग होगा? दो में. एक प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट में और एक डेप्रिसिएशन में. पर प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट आई हैव नॉट ओपन, डेप्रिसिएशन आई हैव ओपन. तो वहां पोस्टिंग करो डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट क्रेडिट बाय प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस 31/3/13. हो गया. तो फर्स्ट ईयर का तीन जर्नल मैंने डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट और मशीनरी अकाउंट में पोस्टिंग कर दिया. करने के बाद सेकेंड ईयर शुरू नहीं करो. इमीडिएटली विल नॉट स्टार्ट द सेकेंड ईयर. First year we will close that one and we will transfer the balance to the next year. Then we will do the posting of second year. One second, you listen. After completing the posting of first year journal, then we will close the first year if balance is there. After that, we will do the posting for the second year. There you see that this side total is 50. There you write 50. So if 50 minus 4 is equal to 46, that is your balance. You will write here by balance C. Later, and next year 1/4/13, you will write here 2 balance B. How much? 46. This is the system. First year posting kiya, balance fund kiya, second year opening mein balance likhne ka. इसका भी सेम थिंग है. वो इसका कोई बैलेंस नहीं आता. बोथ द साइड्स आर इक्वल. सो यू विल नॉट हैव एनी बैलेंस. फर्स्ट ईयर वर्क इज ओवर. नाउ वी विल कम फॉर द सेकंड ईयर. नाउ सेकंड ईयर वी विल डू द पोस्टिंग फास्ट. बट सेकंड ईयर हाउ मेनी जर्नल्स यू आर हैविंग? टू ओनली. आउट ऑफ द टू फर्स्ट वन व्हिच इज दैट डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू मिसिंग. सो दैट यू राइट इट हियर. Here 31/3/14, 31/3/14, 314 डेप्टी सीनियर अकाउंट डेबिट टू मेसनर एंड मेसनर अकाउंट डेबिट बाय डेप्टी सीनियर हाउ मच चार्ज। मतलब सेकंड ईयर का फर्स्ट जर्नल दोनों में आएगा क्यों जर्नल इज लाइक दैट डेप्टी सीनियर अकाउंट डेबिट टू मेसनर मेसनर अकाउंट डेबिट बाय डेप्टी सीनियर और सेकंड ईयर का थर्ड जर्नल सेकंड ईयर का सेकंड जर्नल सॉरी सेकंड ईयर का सेकंड जर्नल इट इज गिवन ऑपरेटर्स अकाउंट डेबिट टू डेप्टी सीनियर दैट मींस 31/3/14 बाय ऑपरेटर्स बस सेकंड ईयर पोस्टिंग इज ओवर नाउ वी फाइंड आउट द बैलेंस दिस इज 46 दिस इज 46 दिस इज 42 दिस इज माय बैलेंस सीडी इज 42 Here you write 1414 to balance BD is 42 and here you will not get balance, you will get both the sides equal. So this is square of account. Second year work is over. Now we go for the third year. Third year again you are getting the two journals. That is what is depreciation account debit 31/3/15 में टू मशीनरी अकाउंट और 4000 या 31/3/15 बाय डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ 4000 एंड हियर यू गेट सेम थिंग 31/3/15 बाय प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट और 4000 बस इसका एक नंबर मार दो दिस इज टोटल देयर इज नो बैलेंस एंड हियर यू विल गेट 42 हियर आल्सो यू विल गेट 42 एंड यू विल गेट बाय बैलेंस सी 38 एंड दैट यू राइट इन द नेक्स्ट ईयर ओपनिंग बैलेंस 1415 टू बैलेंस 38 यहां तक करना है इसका आगे नहीं जाना ओनली 3 इयर्स दिस से सो वी विल फॉलो द 3 इयर्स डेफिनेशन वन सेकंड वी हैव पास्ड द 7 जर्नल ऑल द 7 जर्नल यू गॉट द सो मेनी अकाउंट्स मशीन अकाउंट कैश अकाउंट बैंक अकाउंट डेफिनेशन अकाउंट कंट्रोलर्स अकाउंट बट ऑल अकाउंट वी हैव नॉट ओपन दे सेड टू डू द टू लेजर्स वन इज मशीन अकाउंट एंड इज डेफिनेशन अकाउंट that we have opened machine account and depreciation account and we have done the posting of these two accounts and we have closed it according to the year wise all this 3, 4, 5, 6 all the 7 journal we will not do posting at first first year journal we will post it we will find out the balance transfer to the next year second year we will do again we will close it and we will find out the balance we will transfer to the next year like this third year also we will do And one more point they say that accounting effect of final account for first year. That's it, I think so. Disclose the accounting effect of it in final account of the first year. First year the final account of the accounting effect they say. Accounting effect of the final account means beginning what I said that one. One is called the trading account, second is called the profit loss account, and last is called the balances. This is balances, this is profit and loss account, and this is trading account. This is called final account. Accounting effect bolte hai kya? First we have to write the machinery the balance. Machinery, how much you owe? 50,000. First year. And here we have to write less depreciation. First year kitna hai? 4,000. तो बाहर कितना गया 46 फर्स्ट एफेक्ट सेकेंड एफेक्ट विल राइट गया टू डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट 4 दिस इज सेकेंड एवरी ईयर यू हैव सीन द लास्ट जर्नल इट वॉज पॉपुलर अकाउंट डेबिट टू डेप्रिसिएशन एवरी ईयर लास्ट जर्नल यू हैव पास्ट पॉपुलर अकाउंट डेबिट टू डेप्रिसिएशन That is there, for the last one, they will get this. Go to post to आप लोग पोस्टिंग किया था डेप्यूटेशन अकाउंट में
और वो कॉर्पोरेट अकाउंट में पोस्टिंग हुआ,
तो फाइनल अकाउंट का इफेक्ट 3 साल का नहीं बोलेगा, फाइनल अकाउंट का इफेक्ट 1 साल का ही बोलेगा।
और उसको क्या करना है, फास्ट टैग जो मशीन का प्राइस था, फास्ट टैग का डेप्यूटेशन से डिडक्ट करके निकलना है, या फास्ट टैग और सेकंड टैग कॉर्पोरेट अकाउंट डेबिट में लिख देना, या कुछ नहीं आएगा, या भी कुछ नहीं आएगा, या भी कुछ नहीं आएगा, या भी कुछ नहीं आएगा। 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 सिक्स प्लेसेस आर देयर, आउट ऑफ दैट देयर इज नॉट कम, देयर इज नॉट कम, देयर इज नॉट कम, फोर प्लेसेस विल नॉट कम ऑन ए बैलेंस शीट, दिस इज एसेट साइड एंड दिस इज लायबिलिटी साइड। एसेट साइड यू राइट द कॉस्ट ऑफ द मशीन, फर्स्ट ईयर का कॉस्ट ऑफ द मशीन, फर्स्ट ईयर कॉस्ट ऑफ द मशीन दैट इज 2000 एंड फर्स्ट ईयर का डेप्रिसिएशन माइनस कर, बस फर्स्ट ईयर पे और जो माइनस का वो दैट इज लायबिलिटी ऑफ ऑर्डर्स को डेबिट साइड। That means this expense you have transferred to the profit and loss account. This is the meaning of that. This is the overall idea of the practical sums of the fast method, which is called the straight line method or fixed installment method. And next video I will tell you the second method that is called diminishing balance method. Fast method, if you understand second method, the almost all the things are same. Only the amount will change. That I will tell you next video. And why it is called straight line method? Because if you put this depreciation into the graph book, amount of the depreciation, if you have shown in the graph book, then you will find out, this is suppose the two sides are there in your graph paper. Suppose this is here, first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, and this is amount. Suppose 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000, 5000, thousands of them. Okay. Amount 1000, this is 2000, this is 3000, this is 4000, this is 5000, like that. So if you find out the amount, the year, first year, the amount of depreciation charge. Here the point will come. Second year, the amount of depreciation also charge. Third year, the amount of depreciation also charged. Fourth year, it will go on. Every year, amount of depreciation is charged. And if you put a, if you add this small dot, you will get a straight line. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T, straight line method. इसलिए इसको बोलता है straight line method. Because amount of depreciation if you put into the graph, the graph में straight line में जाएगा, every year amount of depreciation is fixed, for that it is called straight line method. But every year if the amount of depreciation is not fixed, suppose every year amount of depreciation is gradually decreasing, first year 4000, second year suppose 3000 loss हो, third year suppose 3500, suppose 3000 loss हो income, third year suppose 3500, उसके बाद suppose 3000, उसके बाद सपोज 8000, तो इफ यू एड इट इज नॉट ए स्ट्रेट लाइन, ग्रेजुअली इट इज डिक्रीज, लाइन इज स्ट्रेट बट ग्रेजुअली द अमाउंट ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन इज रिड्यूसिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट मेथड इज कॉल्ड द स्ट्रेट लाइन मेथड। अंडरस्टैंड्स, होप यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, इवन दो एट एनी प्लेस एवरी टाइम आई एम टेलिंग यू, डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड यू विल टेल मी, आई विल क्लियर योर डाउट। ओके, follow that one video at least 2 times you watch, and the same time you theoretical part also you read at your home and mark the place, you mark the place where you do not understand, there you will clear your doubt. Okay, bye, all the best.